Welcome you all. In this experiment, we are going to measure prominent lines of mercury spectrum by using spectrometer. To determine wavelength, first we have to do initial adjustment for the spectrometer. Then we have to standardize grating for normal incidence method. Then we have to measure diffraction angle. We will see in detail. Apparatus required for proceeding this experiment: spectrometer, mercury vapor lamp, grating, reading lens and spirit level. These are the parts of the spectrometer. This one, it is telescope which consists of eyepiece, and telescope can be focused with the help of focus knob. This one is collimeter which consists of slit. The slit width can be adjusted with this knob, and this one is prism table over which grating holder is mounted. This one is vernier table. This screw is for locking the telescope rotation, and this one is for fine adjustment. The number of lines per inch in the grating is given in the grating itself. It's 15,000 lines per inch. We know 1 inch will be equal to 0.0254 meter. So, we can calculate the number of lines per meter. 15,000 divided by 0.0254, which will be equal to 5.9 into 10 to the power 5 lines per meter. Least count means the minimum possible measurable value by the instrument, that we are calling it as least count. So, we will see how to calculate least count for the spectrometer. The least count will be equal to 1 main scale division minus 1 vernier scale division. In spectrometer, if you see this scale, 20 main scale divisions will be equal to 10 degree. See, in between 10 degree and 20 degree, there are 20 divisions. So, 20 main scale divisions will be equal to 10 degree. So, value of 1 main scale division will be equal to 10 degree divided by 20, which will be equal to half degree or 30 minutes. The vernier scale consists of 60 divisions. The 60 vernier scale divisions will be equal to 59 main scale divisions. So, 1 vernier scale division will be equal to 59 divided by 60 into main scale division, which we have calculated the value of 1 main scale division is half degree. So, if we are calculating the least count, we will get the value of least count half minute. Now, already we have calculated number of lines per meter in the grating, which is 5.9 into 10 to the power 5 lines per meter. The least count of the spectrometer also we have calculated, which is half minute. Order of the spectrum, we are going to take 1, means first order spectrum we are going to record. Before moving to the demonstration, we have to familiarize with main scale reading and vernier scale coincidence. The vernier scale consists of 60 divisions starting with 0 to 60. Among the 60 divisions, the value corresponds to vernier 0 is the main scale reading. In this case, the main scale reading is 20 degree. See, this one it is 20 degree, here it is 30 degree. So, the vernier 0 corresponds to 20 degree. So, the main scale reading is 20 degree. Among the 60 vernier scale divisions, which one of the vernier scale division is exactly coinciding with the main scale is called vernier scale coincidence. In this case, the 30th division of vernier scale is exactly coinciding with the main scale. So, vernier scale coincidence is 30. Among 60 division, which one of the vernier scale division is exactly coinciding with the main scale, that we are calling it as vernier scale coincidence. Suppose 31st division is coinciding, means the vernier scale coincidence is 31. In this way, we have to note down the main scale reading and vernier scale coincidence.
Now, let us see the demonstration part. The first initial adjustment is telescope. The telescope is focused towards a long distance object and it is adjusted to get clear inverted image of the object. Now the telescope is ready to receive parallel rays. Now the slit is illuminated through mercury vapor lamp. The image of the slit, what we are getting is not clear. Blurred image of the slit we are getting. So we are tuning the
collimator
to get sharp image of the slit. The width of the slit can be adjusted with help of this rotating knob. So then the slit has to be adjusted narrow and vertical with help of this rotating knob. The next initial adjustment is prism table. This will be done with the help of spirit level. The spirit level will be placed over the prism table and three leveling screws will be adjusted to make the air bubble in the center of the spirit level. Now the air bubble is center of the spirit level. So the initial adjustment of prism table is over. Before moving to the experiment, we have to know the purpose of these screws. The two screws attached with the telescope are for arresting the telescope. For example, now the telescope is free to move. If we are locking this screw, the telescope will not move. In this position, if we make fine tune, we can use this screw and we can make the fine adjustment. Similarly, these two screws are for locking the vernier scale. So if it is free, the vernier scale will be freely rotated. If we are locking the screw, we can't rotate the vernier scale. And fine movement in the vernier scale can be made with the help of this screw. Now the telescope is turned to receive direct ray. The slit is adjusted to coincide with the vertical crosswire. In this position, the reading of one vernier scale will be noted.
In this case, the main scale reading is 10 degree.
Now, the telescope is moved through 90 degree and fixed in this position. In this position, the telescope and collimator are exactly perpendicular to each other.
Now, the value of main scale is 100 degree.
The grating is mounted in the grating holder with its ruled surface facing the collimator. Grating holder is rotated slowly till the reflected image from the grating coincide with the vertical crosswire. In this position, grating table is fixed. Now the angle of incidence is 45 degree. Then the vernier table has to be released and it has to be rotated exactly through 45 degree. Then the vernier table has to be locked in this position. Remember, we have to move the grating in clockwise direction, 45 degree in this case. Otherwise, we have to move 45 degree in anti-clockwise directions, so that the grating has to be normal to the incident light.
Now the main scale reading is 55 degree.
Now the grating is normal to the incident light. Then we have to release the telescope and it has to prod to observe the direct image. We have adjusted the grating for normal incidence. Now we can able to measure the angle of diffraction for different colors. Now, if you are rotating the telescope over left side of the direct image, you can observe different colors like violet, blue, green, yellow and red. Similarly, if you are rotating the telescope over the right side of the direct image, you can observe the same violet, blue, green, yellow and red.
To measure diffraction angle,
you move the telescope over left side of the direct image and place the vertical crosshair over the red spectrum
and note down the corresponding readings of vernier A and vernier B. Then
you move the telescope and place it over yellow spectrum and note down the vernier A and vernier B readings in the tabulation.
Similarly, you move the telescope
and place it over green, blue and violet spectrum
and also note down the corresponding readings. Also, you move the telescope over right side of the direct image
and place it over violet, blue, green, yellow and red
and note down the corresponding readings of vernier A and vernier B in the tabulation. Now, I am going to explain how to record diffraction angles for different spectral lines. Let us consider a particular spectral line, for example, violet spectrum. Place the vertical crosswire over the left side of the violet spectral line and note down the vernier A reading. In vernier A, note down the main scale reading and vernier scale coincidence. In this scale, main scale reading is 312 degree 30 minutes. This one it is 320 degree, here it is 330 degree, this one it is 315, 314, 313, 312. So the main scale coincidence is 312.5 degree or 312 degree 30 minutes. The vernier scale coincidence is 5. Fifth division of the vernier scale is exactly coinciding with the main scale. So the vernier scale coincidence is 5. These values you note it down in the tabulation. In the tabulation, the main scale reading is 312 degree 30 minutes, vernier scale coincidence is 5. Vernier scale reading will be equal to vernier scale coincidence into least count. The least count value is half minute. If we multiply with the vernier scale coincidence, we will get 5 into half minute, which will be equal to 2 minutes 30 seconds. So the total reading will be equal to sum of main scale reading plus vernier scale reading. So 312 degree 30 minutes plus 2 minutes 30 seconds. If we are adding 312 degree 32 minutes 30 seconds. We know 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes and 1 minute will be equal to 60 seconds. Similarly, we have to note the mean scale reading and vernier scale coincidence in vernier B. In vernier B, the mean scale reading is 132 degree. The vernier scale coincidence is 56 divisions. That means 56th division is exactly coinciding with the mean scale. Now, note down these values in tabulation. So, mean scale reading is 132 degree, vernier scale coincidence is 56. So, vernier scale reading is 56 into least count half minute, which will be equal to 28 minutes. The total reading, which is sum of mean scale reading and vernier scale reading, which will be equal to 132 degree 28 minutes. Similarly, you note down the values of mean scale reading and vernier scale coincidence for both vernier A and vernier B for the right hand side also. The difference between vernier A values in left hand side and right hand side is written as 2 theta A. The difference between vernier B values in left hand side and right hand side is written as 2 theta B. The average between these two values is written as 2 theta. From 2 theta, the value of theta can be calculated. If we get diffraction angle theta, we can substitute the angle theta in this formula and we can calculate wavelength of the mercury spectrum. So, we have calculated value of theta, the diffraction angle, and m order of the spectrum we have taken first order, n is the number of lines per meter in the grating, so which also we have calculated. By substituting all these values in this formula, we can calculate the wavelength of prominent lines of mercury spectrum. I hope you understood how to determine wavelength of prominent lines of mercury spectrum using spectrometer. Thank you.